From January 20th, there will be a world of challenges awaiting President Donald Trump. Just days before assuming office, Trump sounding a defiant tone to international audiences.
There's no reset button. We're either going to get along or we're not. I hope we get along, but if we don't, that's possible too.
But Trump's foreign policy vision remains unclear.
We're still nowhere near clarity on where Trump stands on certain key issues such as Russia, Syria, ISIS, and so forth.
On the campaign trail, Trump declared he was interested in getting along with Russia. But allegations of Moscow meddling in the presidential election have complicated any future bridge building.
Every American president, Democrat and Republican, frankly, tried to have a reset with Russia. In one form or another, George W. Bush looked into Putin's eyes and saw his soul. President Obama had a reset a year after Putin invaded Georgia. These efforts have all failed, which tells you a lot about President Putin.
While Borshevskaya believes the president might be willing to deal with Russian President Vladimir Putin on Syria, Trump's opposition to the Iranian nuclear deal runs counter to Moscow's plans.
Trump, I think, looks for a win-win deal, and I think the problem is Putin wants America to lose.
Despite a long history in business, Trump's diplomatic chops are untested. Both China trade and foreign policy will be another early hurdle.
I think the Chinese government is not used to a tweeting president, nor is anyone else. And, I mean, this is a Trump idiosyncrasy, but and it certainly has China sort of, I think, a little bit off guard.
America might also be sailing into uncharted waters in the disputed South China Sea.
China has really pushed things to a point where it does beg some kind of a response. It has, in essence, declared the entire South China Sea its lake.
The outgoing Secretary of State is sounding a warning for the new guys.
We're living in a different world. The new administration needs to grab onto that. It is not a world like the world after World War II, where the United States was the only power left standing.
Donald Trump won office campaigning on American bread and butter issues. But as he steps into the Oval Office as president, he'll be confronted by a laundry list of foreign problems too. Tracy Brown, Associated Press. Mr. President,